Previously, in Breaking Point.
Aiden, please tell us, how does it feel to be on the verge of getting behind the wheel for your very first race?
I feel like a little kid. I look around and I'm surrounded by my heroes.
And tell me about Casper Ackerman. How is that relationship coming along?
It wasn't my fault.
Whose fault was it then?
He tried to stop them from signing you. Didn't want to play babysitter. We all feel sorry for you, mate. You never stood a chance with him.
I had a call this week from Christian Horner. You're being watched.
You know what his problem is, don't you? Thinks you're getting too old.
You want respect, you give respect! That's how it works!
How about you give me a little respect?
How about you earn it first?
I'm done.
You what?
I'm retiring.
Why didn't it work out between you two?
He's on more money than me.
What? He didn't want me on the team.
Didn't I? And you thought I was past my best.
So none of this is true?
There's always gossip in the paddock. And ever since he's arrived, there's been one man at the centre of it all. I want us to push for fourth. I want us to beat Butler. And I want that seat to go to you.
So Alfa Romeo potentially on track to really upset AlphaTauri. Butler's closing in on Ackerman. Down the inside he goes! And they hit each other! Butler into the barrier, and that looks to be the end of the race for him. The Dutchman looks to be continuing at.
It's great to see him still in this fight, Crofty.
Good return, Aiden.
What about Casper?
We let Aiden pass.
Let Aiden pass.
We did it.
We did it. Have you seen the crash?
Butler's okay?
Bruised ego, perhaps.
Like bringing a brand new team to the F1 grid.
You know, the first time you see a car, your car, with your branding, your name on it, in an official race, alongside Ferrari, McLaren, Mercedes, that's what it's all about.
You make it sound like a dream come true.
If only.
When did you first get a sense of what was in store for Connor Sport?
2022 season, straight out of the box. The drivers were always going to clash. That was a calculated risk. But the car. The car had problems.
We're midway through the Miami Grand Prix. It's been a cracking race so far, and it's all up for grabs.
Absolutely, Crofty. Some fantastic driving here today. Especially, I have to say, from Aiden Jackson. I don't think I've ever seen the Connor Sport car being put to its paces quite like this.
This is a team, Connor Sport, that have got a lot to prove this season, but Jackson might just be the man to do it.
Okay, Aiden, nice job so far. Let's try and bring that gap down to the car ahead if you can.
Copy that.
You're in the top 10 now. Keep it up. Okay, you've got P5. Russell's ahead of you now. Okay, gaps in the car ahead is 1.1 seconds. They're on old mediums. Perez behind. Okay, the gap behind is 1.7 seconds. Okay, they're on old hard tyres. Our gap to first place is 12.6 seconds. Look after these tyres now and you want to finish the race on this compound. Front is 6.2 seconds. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left.
I'm losing power! Why am I losing power?
Copy that, we see it. We're looking into it. Okay, I'm afraid you're gonna have to retire the car, please, Aidan. Retire the car.
You're joking!
I'm sorry, Aidan. Pull over now, please. Pull over now.
This is getting ridiculous!
And that's agonizing for Jackson. Just a few laps left to go, and he's out of the Miami Grand Prix.
Oh, with every race, the car looks like a constant problem for Konnersport. It must be devastating for the drivers.
Confirmation as the car comes to a halt, the Konnersport's Aidan Jackson won't be seeing the checkered flag today. But it looks like his teammate will. Jackson's DNF puts Devon Butler in a position where he might just be able to secure some points for Konnersport.
Aidan's out.
Yep, engine problem, I'm afraid.
Good job you got me.
All right, Devon, don't push it too hard. We cannot risk losing both cars here.
It's in the bag, mate.
All okay, Aidan?
Yeah, how's Devon doing?
Yeah, he's doing all right, mate. He looks like he's going to bring home some points for the team.
Good for him.
Then it's another. Did you not see what happened out there today?
Aidan, I agree with you 100%. We are doing everything we can. I know the car is not perfect, but...
Andreo, it's every race. Do you know how I look losing easy points like this?
Knock, knock. Sounds like there's a right show going on in here. What am I missing?
Not now, Devon.
Aidan and I were just discussing issues with the car.
Again? I thought that was all in hand. I had no problems today. Smooth. You know what they say, a shoddy workman always blames his tools. mate, you can look at my setup data any time you want. I've told you that, it might help.
And I've told you before, it's not a setup issue. The problem is...
Jackson, that was the problem with the 2022 season. Ask anyone. I mean, at the end of 21, everyone thought Aidan was going to be signed by one of the big three. But guess they couldn't reach an agreement, so we both signed for Konnersport.
And do you think that affected Aidan?
That's no secret. Now, for that 22 season, Jackson was a nightmare.
Into turn two we go now. Butler comes out of the pit lane. Jackson is right there with him. This is dicey, Ant. Neither one of these two wants to give way.
This would have been a lot cleaner if Jackson had just let him go. He's just not giving him an inch.
They continue onwards, still wheel to wheel, almost touching there as well, as we head down the straight towards the next chicane. Nothing to separate either car, and through the chicane we go. And now Jackson sends them both off the track and Butler over a curb. That looked nasty.
I do believe that one of their cars is damaged here, Crofty. I think it's Butler.
Damage, Ant, but also they've lost places too.
Unbelievable and totally unnecessary as well.
Well, one damaged car, places now to make up. What a complete mess that was.
What was that? When did he even think he was going to go?
Okay, calm yourself down. We'll look at it in the debrief later, but right now, I want you to go and get those places back. Come on, let's go.
Gap behind is 1.8 seconds. is 5 laps of fuel remaining. Nice move, keep going. Some information on Leclerc. Okay, they're out of this race. Okay, so the gap to the car behind is 3.4 seconds. Okay, clear. You're in the top 10. Just 2 laps of fuel remaining now. Okay, push, push. Gap to the car behind. 5.9 seconds. And that's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
Hey there, can you raise that lamp about 6 inches, right? Excellent. A butler should always look sharp. So,
at what point in the 22 season was it clear to you that the team was struggling?
Oh, well, right after the Hungarian GP. I may only be the money, but even to me it was obvious. The whole thing was a sham.
Yet again, Connor Sports Jackson and Butler battling it out on track. It seems as if
they... Hang on 2 seconds, Matt.
OK, Devon, Aidan's lapping faster than you. I need you to let him pass, please. Devon, do you copy? Listen to me, I need you to let Aidan pass now.
Butler just completely blanking the order there. Seems like he didn't even acknowledge it.
Too true, but as you can see, no way through for Jackson. No way at all. This Connor Sport rivalry is getting heated on the track here in Hungary.
Okay, car behind trailing us, 5.9 seconds. Work, mate, that brings you up a place. Okay, gap ahead is 1.7 seconds.
10 now. Keep it up. That's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. Gap to the car in front is 2.6 seconds. Right, we've got enough fuel for 3 more laps. Okay, good work. Great pass. We'll be right back. lap of the race. Final lap. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining. Race over, take care of the car on the way in.
Well, a good race out there again today, Aidan. But what we do all want to know, what exactly happened with Devon? It sounded like he completely ignored a direct team order.
Yeah, what do you expect? It's Devon. He was out of order out there. He really needs to rein it in. He's not the only one driving. I'm sure the team will have a lot to say about it.
Well, he did certainly seem to cause you some trouble out there today. And after that and what happened in Canada, what would you say to those wondering if the old Jackson-Butler rivalry is well and truly back?
No, that's in the past, definitely. We're in the same team now. That's what matters. If there's anything that happens between me and Devon on track, it's because we're so focused on making Connorsburg a success. We're bound to tread on each other's toes from time to time.
So issues with Devon aside, how do you feel it went out there today? Do you think the team will be pleased with your performance?
It was a good result, for sure. But to be honest, Natalie, there's always room for improvement. I'll be studying all of the race footage and looking for new opportunities. The team will be doing the same with the car, I'm sure.
So, you mentioned the car there. In that regard, Connorsport's not had the easiest of times so far this season. Has that all been sorted? Are those reliability concerns well and truly behind you?
I hope so. I mean, today was good, yeah. There was no issues with the car. It's always difficult when a driver brings everything they've got and the car lets them down at the last minute. But, you know, I've been told the team has got it all under control, so yeah, we'll see what happens in the next few races.
Well, thank you for chatting with us. Great to have your time.
Okay, I'll leave that in your capable hands. Devon, you had a problem with a team order today?
Didn't happen.
What?
Look, I know everyone's saying I ignored it, but it didn't happen. I never got the order. Check the comms.
Shoddy workman always blames his tools, eh?
Check the comms.
Okay, we check the communication pipeline. Fix it. This cannot happen again.
Typical.
Aidan, listen.
What's the point?
It's just Devon being Devon.
And what? That makes it okay. He's an arrogant...
No, you're right to call him out. But imagine if we didn't give him certain freedoms. He'd be even harder to manage. As his father, I know. Aidan, you're the best driver that we have. And it's right for you to put Devon in his place. He needs it. The team needs it.
Thanks. Between you and me, I don't think this team is right for me. I think...
Honestly, we don't deserve you. And I know that you've been discussed at other teams. So just keep doing what you're doing.
Sure. I'm sorry if I've spoken out of turn. About Devon?
Not at all. You know the best way to keep Devon in his place?
What's that?
Beat it.